With the rising interest in urban agriculture and relocalizing food systems, green roofs really offer an untapped potential for food production, but also for citizens to engage with access to food, food security, and resiliency. Here in Toronto, we have one of the first bylaws for implementing green roofs on new infrastructure. Now, there's a lot of constraints in these extensive green roofs, such as water stress and heat and wind. How can we overcome some of these constraints on extensive green roofs? What crops are most suitable for extensive green roof production? We're interested in transitioning these extensive green roofs into food production. My name is Marnie Isaac. I'm a professor in physical environmental sciences and global development studies here at the University of Toronto Scarborough. I'm also the Canada Research Chair in Agroecosystems and Development. And my research group really focuses broadly on the role of biodiversity in achieving agricultural sustainability. There's a real potential here in Toronto with all of these green roofs to transition some of these extensive green roofs into food production. We've set up a large module system here at the University of Toronto Scarborough on one of the new roofs.
Hi, I'm Adriana Roberto. I'm a second year PhD student in Marnie Isaac's lab and Scott McIver's lab here at UTSC. And right now we're up on the UTSC green roof testing facility at Highland Hall.
In this module system, we have these small modules of shallow substrate about 10 centimeters deep to represent a typical extensive green roof in Toronto.
All the modules here are filled with what is called an extensive FLL substrate. That's the bare minimum substrate you would use in an extensive green roof. What it is a mixture of crushed brick aggregate and city green waste for a bit of organic matter. So it's typically a very harsh growing environment because they're sort of designed to drain fairly quickly. So for your average plant, it doesn't have the high water holding capacity that it would require.
So in our research group, we're developing new models to understand crop plant interactions on green roofs. And we're using an idea called the nurse protege model, where the nurse crop, such as sedum, which is a succulent, stress tolerant crop grown on green roofs, can reduce substrate temperatures and ease the strain of water stress for associated crops. So we've tested about 20 different crops on the green roofs, everything from herbs to leafy greens to small fruits. We've even had some small watermelons growing. So we're looking at a whole range of different functional types of crops and which are best suited for these constrained environments. Well, these extensive green roofs in Toronto may not offer the opportunity to provide high quantity of crops, what they do offer is an opportunity to work with local communities to determine culturally appropriate and culturally relevant food crops, and working with citizens in communities to determine which crops are most desirable in different regions of Toronto.